never tell me I'll have to apologize. I hope your scandals fall. He left me in a hotel, a Hollywood hell. When he was caught cheating, dip his cowardly tail. Run, you better run. Run, you better run, 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 run. You better run. Run, you better run, 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 run. Boy, last time I chased you, you so cute, but boo, it's time to ghost you. You left me in a hotel, Hollywood. Well, oh no, no more, we're going, fuck your horse, time to go. Oh no, going, going, go to your hoe. When he was catching the best that would lead to Elrond, you better run. Run, you better run, 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 run. You better run. Run, you better run, 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 run. Tell me. Tell me the truth before I run from you. Before I run from you, baby, I'm a magic queen. I can see through your gleam. I gaze into the mirror, cause my spirits make it clear. I'm psychic, psycho in the booth, make it push, 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 to make the truth. So you better tell it to me. Hollywood, hell so, he'll never tell me all. Half truth, half lies, I let my scandals fall. He left me in a hotel, a Hollywood hell. And when he was caught cheating, did this guy with me to run. You better run. Run, you better run, 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 run. You better run. Run, you better run, 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 run.
Did you?
I've got a lot of
did
questions.
You put those pictures?
No,
over,
that was that's the actual
that's
video.
That's in the video like that.
So you oh, didn't fuck. Do that. Like she
I didn't,
did that.
That's her video. Okay, that's on YouTube. That's her video. I will link it in the description. And the reason why we opened with the Sika video is because we will actually be closing tonight with a 18-minute Sika vlog that was uploaded today. I normally can't watch her long content, but I was. I mean, Blue Boy, you watched it, and what would you say about it?
I wish it was longer. I couldn't. It's amazing.
It's captivating.
So, circling back to that, like, so she wrote that, she sung that.
Yeah, and I will give you the context of that, and it's important. That's also important for later, for the video we watch later. The context is this was her sugar daddy who literally left her in a Hollywood hotel and told her to find her way back to Illinois.
Well, because I mean that just seems like something that someone would do to someone they hate. Like they would be like I fucking hate this bitch. I'm going to put this all together and like destroy her. Like
that was all. That's all her.
Well, she's doing a pretty good job destroying her life all by herself. Yeah, yeah. So don't think you need help.
Sorry.
Well, I mean, I sent the thumbnail to Blue Boy as soon as it came up, and he said, I was just about to watch that.
And, like, the other thing, so, like, a lot of the timestamp on that photo or whatever it was is, like, 1993. Yeah. Like, how old is she?
I think that was just, well, she's in her 30s. Or, no, she's 30.
Yeah. Right,
okay. I think she's just using a filter, whatever app she's using on her phone. To
come on, dude, see, really in the question. Yeah. But anyway, we're not here specifically for Sika. It is Monegro's Monday. Yes, this is Blue Boy is. It's Monegro's
I've been looking
Monday.
Forward to this forever.
Sloth Cat is with me as always, and then we have some special guest, Black Boy, and the blackest man in Brisbane. Cornville Three Way.
G'day, guys.
Hello, hello, hello. I'm with the blocks. Yeah, we've got a call from Hillborn or I can't remember which channel, the Hillborn or Reborn channel, that we will be going over, and then like I said, we're gonna close out with the Sika video. So Slothcat, before we do that, I'm gonna set the timer. Actually, Cornville Three-Way, can you see the screen? Can you see the names?
I can.
Why don't you, as the guest, can you read the names?
Well, I haven't done this before, but I'll give it my best.
You haven't read names before? You don't do that in your streams?
Yeah, I do. And
okay, so you've done it before. You were just making a joke.
I was trying to make a joke.
All right. Let's get that one out. Get it out of your system now, because if they're gonna land like that, why don't we just stop? Okay.
I'll restrain myself in the future.
Hello, hello, hello. All right, Alexa, set a timer for 90 seconds.
G'day, Tommy M, Outdoor Loser, Lavish, Pussy Destroyer, Dr. Cunt, Leela Daisy, Carl Webering, Faceted Dreamer, Mark Stevens, The Time Machine, Lawn's Mums, Camel Toe, Andy Mayers, Flaps and Clits, Jose Aguirre, J.R. Davis, Shining Eternity, Jew Punishment, Asbury Brad, Omega, Rachel Roberts, Richard Roberts even, sorry.
Rhonda's June Tootsie.
Evil Little McNuggets, Mark Stevens, Silver Turtle Lady, Sad Face 09, Red Sea Dale, Kemi, Punk Pansy, Chicken Tenders, Smuckamuck, Willow Angel, CJ, Ravenheart for You, Blue Boy, Jeffrey Boomhauer, John Fishman, Whoopie Pie, Schmuckamuck, Danny, Brandon, Slothcat, Jerry Anthony, Jinx, and Duchess, Laura Lisa, Brandon, CJ, Chicken Tenders, Dagmaster 12, Tiffany, and Shins Koala, and Gorilla Face Gwen, and Amanda James, and I'm a polynomial purebred, and I'm done.
Wow, that was nice. Thank you. Good job. Alexa off. It's gonna do it anyway. Okay. Alexa off. I read that Slothcat said because of the comment Tommy M made, the bully comment about, you know, those 5 minutes we were late being because Slothcat was whipping up an animation or two. Because of that, the video that was going to be released won't be until tomorrow. So everyone can thank Tommy M for that. And that's the danger, guys. That's why bully comments hurt, okay? So are you guys...
Dude, they really hurt. They really hurt my feelings.
I forgot you were even here, Slothcat. Yeah, Slothcat, how did that make you feel?
That I'm glad you asked. It really hurted my feelings. I just want to make cartoons, but we got people like this. They just don't. Y'all heard just don't this, care about that.
Y'all hurted this man's feelings.
You really did. You heard it. No, you hurt my feelings. You said it wrong.
I'm just repeating what you said. You sound like you're from one of them furniture commercials with a lady with no teeth. Boss man, this man needs to make shitty animations, and he needs a laptop. Let him have it.
With no problem.
With no problem. Let him have it, baby.
All right. Let's do this.
Hello. Hello.
Can you hear me?
Hello.
Hang on. for now.
Barely.
Hear me now? Barely. Hang on. How about now?
Barely.
No. Can you hear me now?
Hello.
Hello, hang on.
He needed an antenna hat. Blue Boy, I put that on you for not suggesting it.
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
What, for anyone to put up with this, okay. They either really like you or they're recording you. Like, no one else. There's middle ground.
I would
like, I'd be, you'd just be like, hey, call me back when you're in a better area.
Yeah, after the second hello, I'm done. We can't do this. Not gonna do it. There's nothing. Unless you're on fire and you really need me to hear that shit, we can talk later. Text me. I hate y'all. I hate when you text someone a yes or no question and then your phone rings. Yes or no doesn't require my phone to ring.
I love you.
Aww.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
No, it's even worse. Baby. What are you doing?
Can you hear me now?
Hello.
Hello. Hang on.
Hold on real quick. And then... So I guess my only question is, what are your thoughts on Blue Boy Reborn and the Lorne World Order, LWO?
Remind me.
The LWO, Reborn, Blue Boy, like Rami, Patrick, J Potato Man.
You know, I've been giving this a lot of thought. I've gone through all the transcripts, reviewed the record online, and I've come to the conclusion that the LWO just isn't that great. I'm Chris Hansen. I'll be watching and listening.
I mean, that sounded official.
Man, what a just a fall from grace, huh?
LWA. Have you never seen an O before? What is that?
I know, it's like he's never seen that letter before. I don't know what the fuck that was.
Hey, Wes, what's the circle? What's the circle you wrote down? Is that a big period? That's well. At first, he said LWL, which was my personal favorite. The LWL. That's not it. All right.
I can't believe he's never heard of us.
it was a really quick jump from needing to be reminded who the LWO were to have given it a lot of thought and happened in that time.
He hasn't been to Indonesia, so he hasn't seen all the work that's being done. The LWO.
I'm coming for that fucker now too.
All right, I get on speaker. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
What the hell is that bed?
Oh, my headset.
It's like you still have the plastic wrap on it, like when you bought it.
I love you, Jamie.
Aw, it came as a bully.
Sorry, you got mad at me to the point where you didn't want to spend time in a meeting.
What? Sorry.
How come it's like, okay, this is what's annoying me. If he does this, like, this that voice, his baby boy voice, but she can't hear him, so then he's like, talks normal, where he's like, Jamie, I love you. And she's like, hello? And he's like, hello, can you hear me? Can you hear me? And then when she's able to hear him, then he goes back to being like, Jamie, I love you.
Yeah, this is
vulnerable. You talk like that again?
Yeah, this is vulnerable. That voice. Well, and I like that the first apology is, I'm sorry for you getting mad at me.
Yeah.
Look, I'm really
don't
sorry.
Apologize for you being a dumbass. Apologize
yeah, I'm a, for look, mad I'm at you sorry for being that you hated that I cheated on you. I hate that I did. I hate that you're so upset about that. You know,
sorry,
like that's
you can't
so
control yourself.
That's a shitty way to start off an apology.
So what's the bullshit you texted me? So because you get caught red-handed, you want to turn it around on me? Are you serious?
Listen, I just woke up. Don't start that. I'm still pissed about you not wanting to spend time with me, but you sure do want to spend time with Will. I don't care if you think it's stupid me being mad about Will or not.
You just said sorry you got mad at me. Don't want to apologize for your actions, though.
I'm sorry you got mad at me to the point where you didn't want to spend time with me.
No, he repeated it. I mean, how hard would it be for him to say, I'm sorry I pissed you off? Because that's what he's saying, right? I'm sorry you got mad at me to the point you didn't want to be around me. Just translates to, I'm sorry I pissed you off.
Yeah,
he could just say, I'm sorry I pissed you off. I was an asshole. Right?
He could. He could. That's what an adult would do. I mean, he can just do what he's already said. He can just say, I'm sorry that, you know, I was impossible to be around.
That's it. Why? And he's done this so many times before. This shit has never worked. So like, why does he keep going back to this well? There's never been any water, but every fucking day he goes down there with his bucket and his rope, and he drops it down in there hoping for some water.
Because he's and
you would get that because
shallow.
You would get it's that because water. It's nothing but wells where you are, right?
That absolutely.
I'll talk about that.
No, I didn't get it at all. There's no whales where I'm at. That's like an old-timey joke. You need to up-to-date that joke.
Up-to-date that joke? Oh, did I hurt your feelings?
You heard my fellas now. What you saying right now is not right.
But I'm not sorry for being mad or jealous about...
That's you blaming me and not taking ownership of your actions.
Thank you,
Jim. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ.
What did he expect? Oh.
I'm taking ownership of my actions right now. I'm sorry that you got mad to the point where you didn't want to...
He almost did it. He almost did. Yeah.
And then he corrected
himself.
That's not taking ownership.
Good catch, Lord.
He won't correct himself on word, wasn't, but he'll catch himself almost apologizing for some shit. Oh, oops.
So close. Whew.
It is taking ownership.
We both own it.
No, it isn't.
I'm sorry about what I did.
And what was that?
No, I agree, Hope. When the robot should have just hung up, it would have been way funnier. Lavish with a donation. So what's the deal with Lauren putting plastic tarps on a clothing line? Legitimately, what's the deal? Are you asking why? Or, I mean, Blue Boy, why don't you take that one anyway? Because you actually saw it, right?
Yeah, it was to prevent people from looking at his property during the 10-mile yard sale. And when we went down there, the tarp had already fallen to the ground for the most part.
Ripped down by angry townspeople who want to be able to see what the local pedo was doing at all times.
It was a windy day. He didn't have it secured, you know, that good.
What?
He had a bunch of wood pallets, like, against... like trash, trying to keep it up. I guess it was very bizarre how he tried to do this, but yeah, that's why.
I mean, when you first saw it and you saw it, what was the feeling that you had when you saw it? Did it make you laugh?
When I saw the tarp down, or just the trailer?
No, when you saw that there was a tarp, period. Like, that he tried to tarp
off. Oh, yeah. House. I mean, yeah, we were laughing. Because it's just, what a ridiculous thing to do. Because if you really wanted to, it didn't go around the whole property. So yeah. If I really wanted to, I could have just peeked around the tarp. You know what I mean? Like, there's the tree line there.
It just made you walk around it. It just made you more curious about what was behind
the
tarp. Right, like anytime you see a house,
on a computer called, you know, definitely not porn.
Right? Like, if you see a house that's tented for fumigation, like, the house stands out because it's just like, right, like you would never look at it, but you tent that shit like a circus and people look at it. You wrap your house like a fucking haunted house and people are gonna stare. And then Xavier came and ripped it down.
It was just such a half-assed plan. Like, he could have taken so much more time to cover this up. He had probably weeks and weeks and weeks to think of things to do.
Yeah.
And he last minute he puts up a plastic sheet around just the front.
Well, that's why I'm hoping it was the Canadians. This is a long con troll. And so this is all their plan, and they came up with this stupid plan for him. And they also are getting him to sell his house, and he's gonna be living in a hole in the ground with a wood plank over it. And that'll be their ultimate, we got him.
That would be great. And then it would be great.
Then you guys will owe them an apology.
Yes, I will. I will apologize to Prepperette if she comes out with the troll.
And Lord,
but I'm not really that sorry because she had to go sleep in his trailer.
I mean, some people will do some things, man, for the troll. Andy Mayer's donated and said, "Make Monday night Mo Negroes 3 hours." A demand from apparently a white man, so he clearly is clearly unaware of how Mo Negroes works. Thank you so much, Andy.
I mean, wait a minute. He put it in capital letters, though.
So you're saying, what are you saying?
He's demanding it.
That is pretty demanding.
I'm saying that it should be looked into. Even though, you know, if he's white, capital letters,
that should be looked into. Is that how you can tell someone's African-American if they type in all caps?
No, they just type in all small caps.
I have no idea what's happening.
Small caps.
Why don't you grab a bologna
sandwich? Here is an example of what you are doing okay.
I love when the robot takes forever.
I am sorry about
what I did. I'm sorry you get upset when I mention Will Big Beautiful Penis.
Well, I'm not listening to the fucking words again.
Whoa.
That was a good example.
He magically woke up there.
I was just making a point. Do you see how that isn't an apology?
I don't care. I don't like them fucking words coming from your mouth, and you continuously want to say them. Of them fucking words gets me, and you don't seem to understand that. You don't care. If you gave a fuck, you would not say those fucking words to me anymore.
I was just making a point.
So goddamn important. Well, it's so goddamn important to you. Mm-hmm. You, and it kills you to not say those words to me.
It kills her to not say those words.
It is so hard for you to not say those words to me.
What does that mean?
Thanks a lot, Jamie. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I was just making a point. Do you see how that isn't an apology?
Warren.
Fuck Will and his big beautiful fucking penis.
Well,
fucking love him. Go fucking marry him. I'm tired of you fucking treating him like he's a god.
Sounds like permission.
Yeah.
You don't fucking see it.
It's at 1 o'clock in the morning that he's doing this.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, and it started off just 7 minutes ago. This was a baby boy apology.
Yes.
And then all that had to be brought up was Will's big beautiful penis, the BBP, and this dude loses his mind. He's not baby boy. He's not tired and hey BB. It's just rage, directly to rage.
But every time you do this shit to me, it fucking kills me.
That's what we're hoping for.
Fucking will is a goddamn important to you.
I was just making a point. Do you see how that isn't an apology?
You're making a point that you gotta say those words. It kills you to not say those words to me. No matter how much you know that I hate him.
I was just making a point. Do you see how that isn't an apology?
Your fucking point sucks. You can't find another way?
You are missing
my feelings don't fucking matter, though.
You are missing the point.
The point is, I'm sorry about what I did.
Right, but that's not what you said.
I'm not sorry about the way you fucking feel about Will. I'm not sorry about the way that I feel about when I get jealous. You don't want me to get fucking jealous? Stop treating him like a goddamn god. I'm fucking sick of it.
Right, especially so you try to get knowing, back with Debbie.
Ooh. Especially knowing that you fucked him. I didn't try to get back with Debbie.
Debbie tried to get back with him.
Let's brush that under to get the back rug. With
Debbie.
Yeah.
What, that you slept with fucking Will?
They're like, right, so you try to get back with Debbie.
But they're like family. They're like brother and sister.
You know, Lord, you know about that kind of
remember?
Thing.
Remember? They're like brother and sister.
I didn't try to get back with Debbie.
Yes, you did.
I was sore enough fucking feelings of memories that I had. Not knowing that my memories were all fucking lies.
Feelings of what? Memories.
Sorting out feelings of memories that he has.
Anyone could see it.
No, it's not obvious.
No, stupid.
It is.
I'm partially fucking pissed because I held her in fucking on a fucking pedestal that she never fucking deserved.
Well, Ed.
That's your fault.
Is it though?
Good one.
Not knowing good that one, she was Debbie. A fucking liar.
Put her at a god level.
And trying to get back with her.
I weren't trying to get back with her.
You can't help but be a flirt.
I believe he said something like, "You are a threat to my relationship with Jamie," or something like that.
That's just flirty banter. Lauren can't help but be who he be, right?
But how is she a threat if Debbie doesn't want him?
Well, you know what no. I mean? Well, but that's here's the thing. Once Lauren turns on the charm, it doesn't matter what Debbie wants. Who can resist?
That's true.
Like, the singing, the penis pictures he's going to send all the time. Like, it's a very comprehensive package. You're going to fall for him. It's just a matter of when.
And that castle. I mean, he's got that castle ready to
move in. Building, he's building up the land. He's building up the value. Have you not seen what the house is worth now?
Oh, he's already... well, absolutely. And he's already started work on the lake. I mean, that's... That moat's going to be complete soon.
Like, I love that call. He's like, well, I can't start tomorrow, but the day after I can start building the house. tomorrow I'm going to be laying in a ditch drunk with Roy, but Wednesday for sure, I'm going to start. I guess I'll make the frame. I don't know. I'll figure it out as I go.
Do lakes have frames? I don't know. We'll find out on Wednesday.
Well, first, I'm gonna dig a lake. So I'll do that, and then I'll lake first, then house. I'm not gonna go stoop. I'm not gonna be dumb this time. Tiffany, that's a bully comment.
Yes, you were. It's pathetic. You are denying it.
No, I weren't. I'm telling you, I weren't trying to get fucking back with her. Mm. I was just sorting out my feelings.
What does that mean?
He was working on it.
Yes, you were. I saw the whole conversation. It was so obvious anyone could see it.
I want trying to get back with her.
Say she is a threat to me.
He was just reminding her of the, you know, the three orgasms he didn't give her. Because that's what platonic friends do.
No, right? Not exactly.
I'm always telling my platonic friends about that. It's just
the funny thing is that if Lauren was in an actual relationship and he wanted to be faithful, he really would tell a woman that he couldn't be friends with her because she would be a threat to us. Because Lauren believes if a man and woman are friends, they are eventually going to have sex.
Absolutely.
So, like, even if he wanted to, be faithful to Jamie, he probably would tell Debbie, like, we can't be friends. You're a threat because we're going to talk, and either I'm going to want to bang, or you're going to want to bang, or we're going to want to mutually bang, and we can't have that, girl. So it was great fucking, but it's been fucking great. I love you.
And then cool, Debbie.
The crush. No, yeah. Yeah, and then Debbie hangs up, pizza bikini, stained with tears. Not going to the beach that day.
Exactly. Because I'm soaring all my feelings. I already told you that. Debbie was with me through a really rough time.
Let's hear you lie your way out of it.
Oh, fuck. What Debbie did with me, it meant a lot to me because it got me past something that...
No, stop.
What exactly did she do with you that got you past anything?
That's none of your concern.
She talked to me
about something that I had a hard time dealing with.
I mean, she got him to admit that he was a predator, but he doesn't acknowledge that, right? That he was a...
Yeah, that's not something he would, you know what I mean? Like, he talks, like, he's not going to be like, you know, this was great, I finally realized I'm a predator, I can move forward. He should. But I just want to know what exactly Debbie did, because Debbie was like kind of a bitch to him.
She was so awesome.
She didn't give him a chance.
She was so awesome.
Did not give him a chance.
As well as so special.
And he loved the way they were together.
Yeah. That's
my favorite Lauren call of all time is the one where she's telling him to go fuck his cocksuckers.
Fuck the fucking cocksucker.
He's like, give me a chance. He's begging her for a chance and yelling at her.
I deserve a chance.
I used to listen to that call on repeat at work. I would just have it playing over and over again.
I deserve a fucking chance. Yeah, that is a great call.
It was for a long time.
I don't want to hear excuses as to why you were trying to cheat.
I weren't trying to cheat. I wasn't trying to get back with Debbie.
You weren't. You hurted him.
Yes, you were.
No, I weren't. I was trying to understand things.
I wasn't by telling to her, you gave her orgasms.
Yeah.
Which I'm pretty sure, didn't Debbie clear that up, that never happened?
Yeah, absolutely. Yes, but he insisted it happened. Which, I mean, that's not flirting, right?
As long as you believe it. As long as you believe it, that's what matters.
It's not like sexual harassment. I mean, if it's going one way,
well,
it wasn't like Debbie's flirting back with him.
Well, I mean, I know. But again, once he turns on he's just turning on the faucet on drip, right? It's just on drip right now. But once he starts
pipes don't freeze.
Once he starts turning it on, though, Debbie's going to melt. That icy veneer will melt, and we'll see the warm, sweet, loving Debbie that allegedly exists, you know. But
reminding
right
her
now,
of the good days.
Yeah, when she was sweet and loving.
Remember when we were reading my chat log? Those were good times.
Those were good. Remember when we were reading that conversation with that girl I try to do things to?
Yeah, happy days.
I'm not seeing enough votes on the poll and likes on the stream, so I will play Thought Crimes Jesse in a fox costume. You don't want.
Hmm. Please, I want no. it. I would
no. no.
I would like. I would like to see that.
Daddy like it. Don't. No. You don't. No.
Daddy like it.
Sloth's gonna get another burger to watch that with.
kept asking about her boyfriend and if he knew you were talking to her. Lord, it was obvious.
I was wondering. I'm not going to say they weren't wondering.
Debbie didn't lie.
Oh, no, Debbie doesn't lie, does she?
Well,
she's so fucking honest, it's unbelievable. Doesn't. Yeah, she's a fucking lying bitch.
Wow.
Burn.
Took her to task twice.
Why has she lied?
Now that's the roast of Lord Armstrong.
You tell me.
Take that fucking paper bag.
You ask her and tell me why she fucking lied to me back then.
When did she lie?
Why it was so important that she play a fucking game with me.
When did
she Debbie lie? Was like the most honest one. She never wanted to be with him.
Well, and it's been years. So this is one of those anger stacks where he is digging as far back in those filing cabinets as his chunky little short arms will reach to see what he can. This was an apology. This was an apology for something that he did to the robot. So why is he bringing up?
Yeah.
And because he tried to be that, play that little flirty game with Debbie. He's going to be like, okay, but yeah, but why are these people fucking with me? That has nothing to do with what you're talking about right now. Like, and this is the shit that like, he's, I can't believe he's still doing this, but this is why this man will die alone. Not because catfish fuck with him. Not even because it's To Catch a Predator. Like, this man would never have been in a successful relationship because he doesn't have enough to offer someone who would just be willing to be with anyone anyway. Like, this dude's a loser. So, like, no matter what, this dude would be a lonely fucking loser who still behaves like he was in grade 8. And I said it that way for my Canadian friends.
When did she lie?
She told me she didn't sleep with fucking Angelo. She told me she wasn't sleeping.
You have a new girlfriend now.
She was.
Yeah, but what about Angelo? Call him Angel.
Why you fucking? Who cares now? Not
wonder.
The what?
What does that matter if you are with me?
Exactly.
Oh, everyone's jealous.
So I was trying to figure things out from back then.
What?
Because you wanted to get back with her. That's the answer.
No, I didn't. Stop answering my questions for me. I didn't want to get back with Debbie.
Oh, you don't like that.
And that go fuck you fucking cocksuckers call, that's my favorite part of that call that Faceted Dreamers just put in the chat where he goes, you have to be on drugs to be with me. And Debbie's like, yes, of course.
Of course. Yes, of course. Yeah, dude, that hits like a sitcom line. And Lauren's reaction to it. Oh, I mean, anyone else would fuck you. That's it. That's the last time we talk.
You can't come back.
You need to be on drugs to be with me, then we're done. Unless I'm the drug dealer. Unless I'm the drug dealer.
But then that call goes for another hour of him just like, give me a chance. Give me a chance that I deserve.
Oh, yeah, I'll fucking talk to him if I have a chance. Lorne, this is crazy. So Lavish made a donation and said someone put a Chris Hansen cutout on his door. Are you saying someone should or that someone did? Because, you see, I think that will be wasted, right? He sees it at the door. I think it should be behind, like, a tree so he can see it from
the distance. Lurking?
And it looks like Chris is standing behind a tree with some binoculars. That's how you get him, because Lorne will be afraid to approach because he's going to give him footage, right? So he would call the police and say Chris Hansen is hiding in the tree line.
I want like a cutout of Chris Hansen sitting in the chair when
Chris in the chair, like a fat heads you put on your wall.
Yeah.
And then, okay, thank you, Lavish. And then Polynomial Purbred said, actually, the package is rather inadequate if the pics are any indication. She can't be talking about Lauren's ample penis. And also, Polynomial Purbred, one thing you might not realize is because it's in and to the left, Lauren's penis is curved for pleasure. They call that
made that way.
That's a boomerang dick in Australia. Like they you go and get a surgery to get that done. But oh, there it's the right because everything.
I was gonna say that.
It's in into the right.
Yeah, the vaginas go to the right over here.
You came to the States. You came to the States and had so many issues until someone pointed out, well, actually, the clips are on the other side here. And you were like,
oh. I had the same issue when I was driving.
The clips are like driving then.
You alone. The fact that you can't just own up to it is frightening.
I'm not going to own up to something that wasn't true. I weren't trying to get back with her.
It is true.
You are telling me that it's true. I'm telling you that that's not true.
Okay.
I was not trying to get back with her.
You were mentioning sexual shit to her. Why?
I wasn't saying sexual shit to her.
Oh my God, if the robot would have said that and he
thought... Yes, you were.
Like what?
Did you tell your boyfriend I made you come 3 times on the phone?
Okay, how's that sexual? Yeah,
being a smart ass.
It's just a funny joke.
You're better off just admitting that you did wrong than trying to convince her that this is a joke.
Yeah, girl, did you like the way I had that ass bent over? Yeah, I was being a smart ass. Like, you remember? Like, how was that your response? Lauren, I saw you want to catch a predator. You looked off. I were being a smart ass. That's what I were doing.
That's sexual shit.
Well, define sexual.
I was being a smart ass to her.
Oh, and he's doubling down.
She wanted to deny
boy said, he would have been better just admitting it at the start, because you're just going to keep going through it. Should have just said, yeah, I was trying to flirt with her, but during that, I realized how much I really wanted to be with you. So I'm not saying I did the good thing. In a way, I'm glad. I'm glad I did, because it's led me here.
A very practiced speech from Cornville Thurlow. Serious cheater and apologizer. You guys heard it here first. This man, that wasn't something he's not a smart man. That's not something, he's not an improv guy. This is, he's the Jordan of Brisbane. So, for him to have that speech prepared like that, Cornville Freeway, I think you should apologize to the chat for your serial cheating. Hello, Mom.
Sorry, chat, for my serial cheating. But I will not accept being called the Jordan of Brisbane. Call me anything else.
I take it back.
That pissed me off.
Okay, so say that to me, and it's him being a smartass.
Oh, bullshit.
Why is that bullshit?
The difference of will is you've actually already slept with him.
Yeah.
Right, it's different for you. What's new?
Oh, I didn't fuck Debbie. I didn't spend time in person with Debbie.
Or anyone.
Jorville.
Fuck off.
What's new? Lawn gets his own rules. It's always different for poor victim Lawn.
Fucking hummingbird coming back to help me again. It was an issue last week too. Yeah. Fuck this hummingbird. That's why we don't have fucking hummingbirds over here, because they're assholes.
Roy was Lauren's lawyer. Roy and some wingtips representing Lauren.
No, it wasn't right for me to say that stuff to Debbie. Even if I was being a smartass, it wasn't right for me to say that stuff to Debbie. And I'm sorry for that.
What?
I was talking sexual to my ex and saying I was going to give her a third chance and that she is a threat to my fiance. But I wasn't trying to get back with her. Yeah, okay, Lorne. You aren't fooling anyone.
I weren't trying to give her a third chance.
So what Tiffany said was, he were being a smartass until he was told she didn't need to coon three times over the phone because Angela was giving it to her for the for real the whole time. Suddenly, it wasn't funny anymore. so that's why the fresh anger at Angelo, that, like, you know, out of nowhere, the one ball wonder again, because he's been giving it to Debbie the for real. Wow. Thank you, Tiffany.
You literally said that.
Meaning even to
you
be a friend.
Said that.
I meant even to be a friend.
No, you
I was
didn't.
Not going to have anything. Yeah, I did.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did.
You don't talk to your friends about Kumin.
I have the messages, Lorne.
Of course you don't. I don't care. You don't know what I meant.
You can't read my intent. It's like reading sarcasm.
No,
you're
it's
reading
in black and white.
I meant that I weren't going to give her a chance to be in my life again.
She didn't need...
She didn't want it. She didn't...
That's
the prize to be in Lauren's life?
Yeah. Might not be what I said. It's what I meant.
Oh, okay.
I weren't giving her a third chance to fucking hurt me again.
Just three coons.
To be in my life and hurt me
you
again.
You get three coons, but not three chances.
See, while I was begging for a chance
her
with
on
her,
the pedestal.
I was just reminding her that she won't be getting a chance with me. Do you see, Jamie, how that works?
No.
It's called a preemptive strike is what it is.
He just wanted to beg for another chance with her, and then when she turned around and said, okay, Lorne, let's do it. He's like, no, fuck you. You had your chance.
I feel like he was building his on deck. Like, he, just in case shit doesn't work out, he wants to make sure that Debbie still remembers the good times they had. So if shit doesn't work here, I'm going to circle back to Debbie. Because I did make her coom those times. Look, she had feelings for me at one time. Why wouldn't she have feelings? Look at me. I'm better now. I've gotten nothing but better with age. Look at my house.
Like a fine wine.
Look how much better my house is now since when I first met her. Sunroof? What? Yeah. I'm that guy.
Sunroof.
Well, first on, I thought very highly of Debbie. Right until I found out she fucking lied to me.
Right there. Preemptive strike? I don't know what you mean.
Right, so right after you found out she slept with Angelo, you said, I was going to give you a third chance. That's not friendship, and you know it. Stop lying.
It meant friendship. I'm with you. I wasn't going to cheat on you.
Stop lying.
I weren't trying to give her that kind of third chance.
Stop lying.
I'm not going to argue whether or not I've been lying. I'm not lying.
Thought crime. Spies are listening. Thought crime. To what you're typing. Thought crime. Paranoia sing. Be careful what you say. Thought crime, written evidence. Thought crime, made with common sense. Thought.
I don't want
that
to do
real shit right there. Oh, please do it again.
You're so sick and tired of the Photoshop.
I weren't gonna cheat on you.
This is pathetic. You can't own up to what you did.
It's pathetic that you won't take my fucking words for it. You want to insist that I meant something else.
I'm reading your words. I know what your intent was.
No, you don't know what my intent was.
You don't have to tell me, I see it.
I'm not owning up to any intent to want to get back with Debbie. I'm not owning up to any intent to want to get back with Debbie, because that's not what I wanted. I was never going to cheat on you.
Debbie brought me up countless times when you talking about a relationship and sexual shit, and you ignored it every time.
So I wanted her to ask questions.
Every time.
What questions?
I wanted her to answer my questions. I wanted fucking answers to questions. I'm not bullshitting you.
Yes, you are.
No, I'm not.
Hey, so for context, because I remember the call, but I don't really remember. What was it that he wanted from... Why did they even talk?
Because he wanted another chance with her.
No, I'm saying, what was the point? What was the reason why they got in contact together? Oh, wait, hold on. Blue Boy's back. Blue Boy.
Sorry, what was that?
What was the reason why Debbie and Lorne got in contact during this call? This, whatever happened?
Oh, I wasn't around during this time, so I have no idea.
So you don't know shit?
Yes.
All right, does anyone know?
Mm-mm.
Well, I didn't, Slothcat, when I say anyone, I'm clearly not referring to.
Maybe Reborn would probably know. Maybe Tiffany.
She was avoiding answering my questions. She was avoiding answering my questions. I wanted answers to them.
It's sad you think I'm this stupid.
It's sad that you think I think that way.
Oh, we're gonna keep doing this, huh, Bugs Bunny?
This was text.
It's sad that you don't want to hear the words that.
What was that?
This stuff that he's talking about, they're talking about, this wasn't a call, this was text between them.
Okay.
That occurred after he got out of jail, obviously the second time. But I don't know the context exactly why.
Okay. All right. So he was with Jamie and there was a text conversation with Debbie.
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
That I'm saying, you want to stick to the words that you think. You ask me, but you think you know the answer already, so you're sticking with what you think you know. It doesn't matter what I say.
Right, just like when you did that to me about Will's drawing.
Oh.
Will's drawing bothers me because I know that you've already had sex with him.
What drawing?
Will made a drawing of Jamie with big boobs and Lorne crying and
Hold on. What? Yeah, okay. What now?
And Will was like sitting on her boobs. Like it was like this, it was like a stupid cartoony little drawing that Will made.
Lorne got
mad about it because
sitting on Jamie's giant breast?
Yeah, it was something like that. Like she had these huge boobs that Will was like sitting on or like standing in between them or something like that.
Like
and...
Will Mix a Lot? Dude, that sounds like an amazing rap video. Jamie's got freaks.
And then Lorne in the picture is like crying or something like that, and he got mad.
Does that picture exist anywhere?
I'd love to see that.
Yeah, and Reborn has it.
Okay, why is it not on a t-shirt? I would buy that shirt. Actually, I don't want that on a t-shirt. I don't want that on a t-shirt.
I don't know if you want to walk around with that.
Yeah, be a lot of explaining.
Don't put that on a t-shirt.
Different, right, of course. Lorne gets an excuse.
bothers me because I know you've spent time in person with him.
Yeah, that's it. Baby got three.
I'm not going to say that I was right in what I did because I weren't, and I'm sorry.
You weren't.
But I'm not going to say that I was trying to get back with Debbie because I weren't trying to get back with her.
Stop saying it.
I just wanted answers.
How do you choose wrong almost every time?
Me saying the third chance, there weren't any third chance about getting back in a relationship. I was just talking about a friendship. I didn't want her hurting me again. I trusted her so much the first time that it hurt me to find out that she lied to me. Well, she told me that she would never lie to me.
But okay, so no, but no, she did.
She didn't. When did she say that?
Even if she said that, when she lied to you, then that too was a lie. You don't need closure on that. You don't share kids. You weren't married. You didn't have a business together, and you were betrayed. You never even met in person. Who gives a shit? Like,
right. You have a new girlfriend now.
When you have a history of well, Cornville, and you would know this. When you have a history of being a cheater and cheating on people, you don't revisit those past relationships because that's how you get caught up in bullshit, right?
Never. That's the rules, man.
You never look back. You tell every woman what?
What? I'm breaking up.
He tried to entrap you right there.
Debbie kept trying to get the conversation on your fiance, and you continuously went back to having phone sex and giving her more chances and asking if her boyfriend is upset you are talking to her. Spare me this bullshit and just own up to it. Jesus Christ.
I am not going to own up to wanting to get back with Debbie. So I weren't trying to get back with Debbie.
Okay, good night.
And I won't.
Oh. Guys, I think that's a good spot to drop in our first new sponsor, Gravy Train. They loved what we did last week, guys. They Gravy Train sales skyrocketed, and not a lot of deaths this time. So, Gravy Train.
Oh, Marge, Harry's boss is coming for dinner, and I ran out of food.
Don't worry, Harriet. Here.
Gravy Train? But suppose he prefers his food dry.
You don't have to make the gravy to enjoy meaty-tasting Gravy Train. You can serve it dry or mixed with water to make gravy. It's meaty-tasting and completely nutritious either way.
Mmm, this Gravy Train is delicious, crunchy dry.
It's delicious with its gravy, too.
Gaines Gravy Train dog food. Tastes good with gravy, tastes good without.
Now, use the promo code MONEGROS at checkout
for
87% off.
You're going to get 13% off. You're going to pay 80%. They're not giving it away. So, no death means no profit. No, that's not actually how it works for Gravy Train. They don't want that.
Why would you hang up on me?
Commercial was horrifying.
I don't want to hear lies and bullshit.
I tell you what the truth is and you don't want to hear it. You want to hear what you want to hear. You don't care if it's true whether or not I tell you. It's what you want to hear is what you want to hear.
Your intent was so transparent anyone can see it.
My intent was not to get back with Debbie. I was not going to cheat on you.
Yes, it was.
No, it was not.
I mean,
you're telling me what my intent was.
Right. I mean, the minute you start talking about sexual things with this person, you are cheating. If you're in a relationship, you would be cheating, right? You don't have to actually do the physical act. Once you start, if Lauren would be mad about it, if Lauren would consider it cheating, then it should be cheating. And he absolutely would consider that cheating. Like, look how he got when she just mentioned Will's big, beautiful penis, how mad he got. But, like, he can talk to Debbie about making her coom three times? Come on. In the same call, he's mad.
You're not listening to what I'm telling you.
Don't tell Jamie we are talking.
Oh, well, that was to protect you.
I didn't tell her not to tell you.
Yes, you did.
I did not. Oh, well, yeah, I did. Because I didn't want you getting upset and thinking that she was a threat. I didn't want you to get upset because I knew you thought she was a threat. I just wanted answers to my questions. I wanted to sort out my feelings, and I did. It didn't mean that I was going to cheat on you. I never had any intention of cheating on you. Just wanted to sort my feelings out from back then.
You didn't want me to know because she was a threat. That again shows your intent, so stop lying.
It doesn't show my intent. I didn't want you getting upset.
I never said she was a threat, you did. I never said she was a threat.
You felt like she was.
Oh my God,
you felt like
she was. I never said she was a threat.
He really is trying to turn it into he did this for her.
Yeah.
Even down to the reason why I told her not to contact you. Is why I'm protecting you. That's crazy. The flips this man can go through in his head to justify his bullshit. Do you think it worked with Mama Gwen at any point? No, I'm being serious. Do you think this ever worked with Mama? Because why would he keep doing this unless it worked for him? Like, look at the way he grooms. He grooms everyone the same way, with right down to the same method he used with Kayla. He will use today. It had to have worked for him at one time, right? Because he's a creature of habit. He's going to do the same shit over and over again. So this had to have worked at some point, or he wouldn't continue doing it.
Well, see,
I don't know.
You're assuming that he's like, you know, normal. Like, well, normal people.
No,
yeah,
no,
these,
that's
he
not
does
normal.
These online, the online relationships he keeps doing them, even though they never work. I think he's just a crazy person.
Yeah, but I'm saying, but he is a crazy person, but it's the same crazy. It's the same recipe each time, right?
Yeah, because I think he just thinks eventually it's going to work, like a gambler, like losing money.
It had to have worked for him at one point because he was the baby, right?
Hmm.
He was the baby, and so as the baby, you can get away with more shit. And I mean, like, look at even the way he talks when he gets in baby boy mode all the time. That's probably the last time this shit worked for him, and he reverts back to that whenever he's in trouble.
Yeah, I mean, I think this kind of stuff probably did work with, you know,
Even talking to Chris, he baby boy mode and then went off on some different story about Amanda James.
Yeah, like, but it's either worked with her either because, you know, she's a pushover and you know, he's her son, or maybe it's just a lot less effort just to go, okay,
she was done. She's like, you know what? I've raised my kids. Like, I'm done. What's the worst that could happen?
Yeah.
What's it going to be? A pedophile?
smash cut to now.
Guys, I need more votes. We need more no, I am not insane votes so I can close the poll. Thank you.
The way you acted to me, you felt like she was.
I never said she was a threat.
Fine.
I love the change.
You gotta fucking repeat yourself. Jesus Christ.
Stop putting words in my fucking mouth. And keep going on and on about how I don't listen and hear what I want. You do that every time I explain shit to you.
Yeah, because I tell you the way I feel, the way I think, and you tell me it's something different.
Because your way is stupid.
My answers are never good enough, and you just believe what you want.
Because you want my answer to be what your answer is. And that's not the case.
No, I don't. Shut the fuck you up.
Huh?
No, I don't. Shut the fuck up.
Yeah, you do. Because I told you I don't want them that weren't trying to get back to, with Debbie. And you tell me that I was.
Yes, you were.
No, I was not. I weren't giving her a third chance. I weren't giving her a third chance of being friends.
No, Lorne, you weren't.
I was not going to give her a third chance of being friends because of what she did.
I can read the conversation. How do you not get it?
If she did something so horrible, like lie to him all the time, why would he even want to give her a chance to be friends, even?
Exactly. Exactly.
We'll give him a minute. Give him a minute to think about that so he can say, well, I know that you would want to keep me to keep her around as a friend to prove to you that I can be friends with people without wanting to have sex with them. But so I needed to let her know that before I could do that, I need to be able to trust her again. And to do that, I needed to know why she did the things that she did. And during the course of that conversation about friendship, I also let her know that despite the way I rocked her fucking world 3 times, okay, that we couldn't do that again because I'm with you. So I am sorry that I felt the need to let her know that you're my angel. You're my sweet baby. That's my bad. And that's it. You write this down, Cornville.
I agree. I think you're exactly right. And see, the reason that he ignored every time that she brought up Jamie, because he knew that was just a tactic so she would stop feeling so attracted to him. Yep. She was trying to bring up his current girlfriend just to try to remind herself that,
she was trying to give me strength. Give me strength.
Yeah, that's it. He's taken, Debbie. He's taken. You just need to let it go.
Stop it,
it's hard.
Man-eater. Yeah, hard. Yeah. When you see a prize like this, you got gold fever. You're going to go for that gold. And this man is a gold medal. Look at that face. Look at that. Just imagine.
That could be the first thing you see in the morning and the last thing you see.
Imagine that face kissing all over your butt.
Trying to get back with her. I'm happy being with you.
You guys are bad at voting.
I just wanted answers to questions that I had back then.
Lorne, it's black and white on the texts you were.
I was not trying to get back with her.
Yes, you were.
No, I weren't.
Anytime I was brought up, you ignored it.
Because I wanted her to answer my questions.
Wow.
She kept avoiding my questions.
To see if you wanted to get back with her.
And I didn't want to get back with her. I just wanted answers to my questions.
You just started saying yes.
What was the question he had for her?
I don't know.
I'm sure I remember.
Besides, like, did you tell your boyfriend I made you come 3 times?
Yeah,
like,
why was that? Answers to my questions.
That's a question. That's a question. That's sometimes you need to know. Hippie Lincoln donated and said, Lorne's mom's camel toe makes me scream with delight. Happy late anniversary, beautiful.
That's lovely.
That is very lovely.
That's a very sweet anniversary gift.
Yeah. Lorne's mom's camel makes me scream with delight. So happy anniversary. Slothcat, do you have anything to say for the anniversary couple?
That's a buff-ass frog in that picture.
He's wearing a cop hat.
Oh,
yeah, and he's a cop.
I don't fuck with cops, and I don't fuck with frogs. A frog cop? Nah. Go ahead, Slothcat, say it in your way.
I don't fuck with them. I don't fuck with cops. I don't fuck with frogs.
And you really just said you. Why are you saying that? Thank you.
Whatever, Lorne, you won't convince me, so stop trying.
Of course not.
None of that shit that happened back then makes any sense. And it bothers me that I was lied to the whole time. So I thought highly of Debbie. I didn't think she would lie to me like that. Especially with as much as Winnie had already lied
to me. I don't want to hear your excuses. Did you not hear me?
You don't want to hear what's inside me, what's bothering me. Why I did what I did, I know.
I don't care why you wanted to get back with Debbie.
I did not want to get back with Debbie.
You can talk to your exes about your sexual past, but if I do it with Will, it's DEFCON 5.
You're in person with Will.
Let me guess. It's different.
I love his face in that picture that Reborn uses.
Yeah, it's great.
Yep.
Why snap that photo?
You did?
Send it. No, I said why. Like, yeah. Why would you take that picture and then send it, Nick?
That makes quite a difference.
That's a sexy face.
Lorne, I've told you this before and I don't think you get it. If I wanted to fuck him, I would fuck him. Ooh,
I don't like the sound of that. That's not like a threat, Lorne.
So why won't you stop saying those words to me that you know bug me? I hate hearing you say those words. It hurts.
It's a reality.
You say it more than me, and I said it for a reason tonight, but you didn't listen.
Here's the deal, Jessica Biel.
I'm here, Dan.
Got people worried that
you're here was alone. Your apology to me for talking to your ex about how she's a threat and bringing up phone sex. I'm sorry you got mad at me and didn't want to talk to me today.
Yeah. Passive aggressive.
What a shit apology. Blame me, not you.
I shouldn't have talked to Debbie that way. And I'm sorry about that. I weren't trying to have phone sex with her. Just I wasn't trying to get back with her.
He just can't stop it. I shouldn't have talked to her that way, and I'm sorry. Because none of the extra qualification, like once you just leave it at the blanket, that you shouldn't have done it and you're sorry, because now he goes into the excuse mode, and that's where he loses the room.
And he had the room before this, like, well, everything was going really well.
This apology is going great. This is exactly how he envisioned it going.
He's just dropped the ball now.
I was being a smart ass and I should not have done that.
See? Yeah.
And I'm sorry about that.
I didn't even see Will tonight, but apparently I was with him all night. But talk shit and expect me to accept it because it's quite different. Quote different.
He's thinking.
How do you want ridiculous. Me to say it's not different? How do you want me to say it's not different?
You've been with Will before.
Doesn't matter.
You've slept with Will before.
Well, don't avoid the point.
You are in person with him.
Well, don't avoid the point.
All the time.
Accuse me of shit yet again.
No, I'm just telling you, it bothers me.
Like, if Lorne got on the phone, and as Will was walking out of the room, he said, "Oh, does Lorne know that I used to like fuck you in that skirt?" And Lorne heard that, even if it was just something that he was saying, Lorne would be so. Why are you even thinking about it? Why is that even a thought in his head? Like, so, like, for him to even justify it, it doesn't make any fucking sense. Mm-hmm. Why does he think anyone will buy this bullshit? Like, he would.
You did, Lorne.
I'm sorry for being a little bitch.
You accused me of hanging out with Will instead of you.
I'm your bitch. Yeah, but I laughed and called me a bitch.
What's so ridiculous? Well, he used to do it all the time.
Yeah, you used to put up with it.
What is so ridiculous about that?
So again, you want to go on and on about how you don't like when I assume and tell you what you think and do, but you can do it as much as you want.
No, it's not right for me to do as much as I want. Just want to understand why you treat him like he's so much more than me.
Because he is.
Oh, shut the fuck up.
No, I ain't going to shut the fuck up. You don't want to hear the fucking things that are in my head.
That is an understatement. You really don't want to That is a warning.
The only people interested in what's in his head is rape class, and that's why he's still there. The one people who want to know, he's not saying anything to. But he'll talk to Debbie about how many times. Hey, how about you admit to rape class? How many times you did the shit that you did? Stop talking to Debbie. Debbie don't want you. Debbie's getting dicked down by Angel. Call him Angel, all the time.
Are we engaged or not? That doesn't seem to count to you one bit.
We weren't with jealous, legit jealous.
Yeah, we were engaged, and it does count to me.
I love you.
Clearly, it doesn't.
I'm not going to tell you that it doesn't bother me. Huh?
Clearly, it doesn't.
Yeah, it does. I'm not going to tell you that it doesn't bother me. I'm not going to tell you that it doesn't bother me where you spend so much time with him. Especially when he has to put lotion on your body. I haven't seen him in days.
What the fuck are you talking about?
This fucking closeness that you and Will have. I'm not going to tell you that it doesn't bother me.
All right, I'm done. I shouldn't have even called. You get pissy with me and accuse me of shit just because I didn't want to talk to you today after you were caught red-handed, then want to turn it around on me. Go fuck your...
All right, hold on here. We got a confirmation from Hillborn that the drawing does exist, and Lauren saw them and wasn't happy about it. But Hillborn, where is that drawing now? Can we see that drawing? Because I would really like to see it. And Slothcat, can you... Dan, I know you saw it, but Dan, he's my man, said, is Slothcat alive? He's always so quiet. I worry.
I'm here, Dan.
Yeah,
trust me. I'm out here.
We get the perfect amount of Slothcat. We get the perfect... He's we just want a little bit of Slothcat.
You don't want too much. I've been told it's damaging. It's damaging for too much. I would not recommend it.
Yourself.
Okay. Hillborn said, yeah, I was planning on showing them whenever we hear him react to them. Okay, so whatever call that is. So sometime in 2024, 2025, we'll get to that. We'll probably get to that call. So I look forward to it. Thank you, Hillborn. You'd be up.
Why would you say that?
Why would you say that? Oh.
Why would you say that?
Because it's the truth.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is, Lorne.
Jamie, I love you, and you and I are all the only thing that I care about. I'm sorry that I tried to sort through my feelings with Debbie. It didn't mean that I was going to cheat on you, and it didn't mean that I wanted to leave you.
What does that have to do with what I said?
And I'm not turning things around. I'm telling you things that bothered me, too. I did something that bothered you. No.
Listen.
Fuck off upstairs. I agree, Kim. Is he waiting for a message from Jamie? Some heartfelt message? Hillborn said, I have to make them stream friendly. There's dicks in them.
I didn't call you because of your conversation with Debbie and you knew I was mad about it. So what do? Accuse me of spending time with Will instead and the proceed to tell me how I fucked him. Go fuck yourself. Mm-hmm. That's exactly what you did. Don't try and twist facts to make you look innocent.
Alright, turn it around, Lauren. Let's see it.
Not gonna tell you that I was wrong.
I hate when he does that shit.
I'm not going to tell you that I was wrong.
That's what I was wondering.
He does that like, I'm not going to tell you I shouldn't be upset with myself. Well, no one's saying that. But it's like, it's a way to buy a little extra time for himself to think about what he wants to say.
Am I going to say I'm perfect? No.
Is murder okay? Absolutely not. Did I murder someone? Absolutely. You know, like, it's just, he's buying himself a little extra time for that peanut brain to kick on, so he can, and then he's like, boom, got it. And he never does. Bullseye.
I was wrong to talk to Debbie. I was wrong to talk to her like I did. I'm sorry that I twisted it around to blame you.
All right, now shut up. But like at this point, the damage is done. If this was real, that trust is gone. Mm-hmm. Especially after
I shouldn't have talked to Debbie like I did. And I'm sorry. It's important that you know I weren't trying to get back with her. I just wanted answers.
I wasn't to trying what? To cheat on you. But I shouldn't have talked to her like I did.
Great, we could sorted that out. You already know to what? Does your boyfriend know that I made you come a bunch of times?
I need to know or else I can't move on.
Who wouldn't want to know that kind of thing? I call Ego, what's up? Hey, I know we haven't talked in a long time, but how's your husband? Does he know? Yeah, you got to know these things. These are the things that keep blowing up at night.
How do you get closure from a past relationship unless you know their new partner knows how many times you made
how many
come?
Times like, you bang? I want to, how, like... And if it was a lot, like, what range are you telling this person?
I don't need exact numbers. I just need to know.
Get him on the phone. Get him in front of you right now and put me on speaker.
Can I go to bed now?
You can if you want.
You can if you want to.
No, baby boy.
This call was brought to you by the Lawn World Order. Well,
other than that part, this last part, that was a great call. Yeah, that was really good. What did you think of that, Slothcat?
I think he should have just admitted to everything right from the beginning.
Yeah.
It would have saved him a lot of time.
A lot of time in trouble. It's always funny when Lauren gets on the phone and in one mood and gets off the phone in a completely different mood. But it's never happy. I can't think of one call where he got off the phone and he was like, man, I can't wait till the next time we talk. I'm so in love. I can't wait to talk to her again.
Mm-hmm. The roller coaster. I love it.
But it's a roller coaster, but like it's a roller coaster that just keeps going down. The roller coaster supposed to be peaks. This is just a hill. He's just sliding down a hill, steadily rolling. And every time he gets up to right himself, he just falls back down and keeps tumbling down.
Yep.
All right, so yeah, I did say we were gonna do some we're gonna do some Sika. We do have a Sika video that we're gonna watch now. So yeah, that was it for the Lauren call. But we do have a Sika video that Blue Boy and I are very excited to share.
The real reason we're all here.
Yeah, the beginning part was just the warm up to the main event, which is the 30-year-old woman. Crying about not well, you'll see. But before we do that, we do have the first. No, I said Gravy Train was our new sponsor, but this is the first LWO Gravy Train commercial that I've been hired to put together. So,
do you love your dog? Then feed him the best: big chunks of real meat, wholesome ingredients, and no fillers. If your dog is just okay, feed that fucker Gravy Train. With orange pieces, green pieces, and yellow pieces, we guarantee your dog will eat several colors of food in each steamy bowl. Did some dogs die eating Gravy Train? Sure, but some people die drinking water. Are you going to stop giving your dog water because you want to be a little whiny bitch? If you love your dog, feed them something else. But for the rest of us, all aboard the Gravy Train, the official gravy-based snack of the LWO.
Gravy.
Good, right?
Well, I'm hungry. Really anyone else.
That's
messed up, man. LWO.
Anything you put in front of them to promote, they'll do it, as you've seen from their musical choices.
I love chunky gravy.
I like to mix my own gravy in my dog food bowl. Who wouldn't? Who wouldn't? All right, let's get to Oh shit, she took down the video.
No, she did. Oh.
Fucking took down
it.
But
did
I mean,
you download it?
I did download it, but I didn't re-upload it because I didn't want the
do it now. You downloaded it? Thank God.
It's 20 minutes long. You know how long it's gonna I'm not reborn. I'm not gonna sit here and like, will you guys wait while I upload a call? I'm not an asshole. I'm not reborn. The asshole.
You have ruined Blue Boy's night.
It's fine. I will have it uploaded for the next one. But I have two Perry Caravello anger blow ups that we can play us out with. Yeah, no, the Sika video, it's really good, but luckily I did download it, so I will have it uploaded.
Wait, you have another Sika video though?
What do you mean, like music video? or well, oh, I do. We can, you want to play? You want to just play some Sika?
I can. Yeah, just play a different Sika video.
Yeah, I'll get. I'll get a different Sika video. Hold on.
Okay.
Let me get it. Let me just do this real quick and play. I'll just play something.
Thank you.
Here, we'll do this.
And hot chocolate, those are the hot drinks that you serve. So get set, hot cups come in two sizes, small and large, you fill as the need arises. Coffee's holding time is 30 minutes, that's so long. It can stay there before it starts, it tastes too strong. Hot, hot, careful when you pour it, hold it steady upon the counter, let it set. Until our coffee reaches the line, pop a top on it, gets a lid every time. Wendy's coffee tastes so fine. Hot drinks really get you going, warms you up when you feel you're slowing. Wendy's, we always serve it right away. Have a smile and have a nice day. Next is the cafe brew, it's just like coffee. Use the orange pot and makes it easier to see. But if you're using the packets in your store, put it in the small cup and furthermore, add hot water up to the line and stir it in. Put a lid on and serve it on a tray again.
Right. All right.
That guy did a really good job, man. He did a really good job.
If he did such a good job, why did you get fired 3 times from Wendy's for fucking up hot drinks? Why?
The orange one is decaf, Flocka.
Yeah, it's like the gravy train. The orange pieces are carrot. It couldn't be easier. The orange one is decaf. And you're like, hold on, can I play the hot drink? No, stop playing the fucking hot drink song. No one needs, it's like a joke thing for training, Sloth Cat.
But he did do a good job, though.
He put in way too much effort into that.
Yeah, cold drinks. I mean, cold drinks is arguably better. Some people say cold drinks is better. I'm saying hot drinks.
What's cold drinks?
Oh, you'll see. So this is a secret video. This is called Boyfriend Says I Am Not Cute with I can't say his name, but this was she called him her 90-day fiance. He was the Chinese boyfriend, as she called him, that was addicted to VR porn. And the VR porn was making him schizophrenic, not the actual schizophrenia. So this is Boyfriend Says I Am Not Cute. It might be a slow burn in the beginning. I can't remember, but I do remember he comes in brushing his teeth at one point. So yeah, we'll give this one a go.
Most of my body think you're very cute. This makes sense. Like most Americans maybe think you're cute.
Right.
They're in the middle of a fight, so of course you turn on her camera. But what he's explaining to her is, look, most Americans might think you're cute. I do not.
I don't think I'm cute.
Yeah, that's why I control them. You know, oppression. The sun is not that out. No. Like they say one or two things to you, but then I kick them out. Like they don't get to participate in you. Maybe they can learn to like you at some point.
Yeah, but, maybe I can learn to like you too.
Well, that's just
maybe me. Someday like I'll me. Think you're cute.
Most of me like you. So.
You were cute the first day, but you just get uglier and uglier the more that I hear you talk.
Why is she recording this?
Because she said this is her third income stream. It's the OnlyFans that she's going to continue doing through the whole pregnancy, whatever job she does, and this is her third revenue stream. There's a part. There's a hour long video where they are eating like the worst looking Chinese buffet I've ever seen.
That video disturbs the fuck out of me.
He's like, he's going to start playing music and she gets mad. No, I can't get demonetized. So he comes back with harmonica. With harmonica, he's just like...
Like, this is like fan footage horror.
Very uncomfortable.
What are you trying to do? Telling me this?
No, I'm not trying.
There's microorganisms in your body that don't think I'm cute.
That was what he said.
What?
Yes, the microorganisms.
I think you're not very cute either.
That's one of you that doesn't think I'm cute.
That's one of the
microorganisms. One of you that thinks I'm cute, which I'm probably in second, and tell me I'm cute. Tell me I'm cute.
What if I pull my hair back? Tell me I'm not cute now.
Is this seriously am I not cute fight?
Yes.
This is a cute fight.
Yes.
They're both, he's very cute. What do you mean?
You haven't seen it enough to yet.
As what? What am I portraying you as?
What you portrayed me in the last video, the continuation of the last video.
How? I'm portraying real life. I'm just filming real life. What am I doing?
Filming real life. Yes.
I'm filming the actual real life.
Like, these are 30-year-old adults. That's fucking so weird.
This guy's amazing.
This is why you're trying to portray it.
How am I portraying anything? You just told me I'm not cute.
We are both act different when there's camera on.
I don't act different. You do.
Act different. You're talking to the camera like your eyes are on the camera.
I act the same.
I act different.
Exactly. I believe that.
You act
different. Act different. Look, I'm doing karate.
I only do this when the camera's on.
There's videos of this man just like talking to himself, like voices in his head. He's very not well.
Yeah. The video I didn't play was I think it's called like schizophrenic boyfriend. Hold on. I can tell you what it's called. VR.
So what do you do that? This says so, daily vlog. So does she do this stuff daily?
Oh yeah, constantly. The video that we didn't get to show today. It's her crying because she's 30 and she doesn't have any. Her parents don't let her have any friends. She's not allowed to have friends come over. And she tells the story. She's pregnant. She's 9 weeks pregnant. And she tells the story.
With a man?
Go ahead.
How'd she meet this man?
Well, she met him at the... She snuck out of the house to meet him at the gas station. And then they went to the lake. And they spent 3 hours making sex in the car. And now she's pregnant. But he has a girlfriend that he lives with.
Who he lives with.
So, and he's not allowed to come over to her. He doesn't want to come over to her house to meet her parents. So they're not allowed to hang out.
The four videos there that are in your playlist, there's four videos, two of them are about VR porn.
This is her playlist. This is not my playlist. On her channel.
That's a lot.
Let's
Boyfriend addicted to VR porn.
Yeah, I didn't realize this one. I'm sorry. We need to watch this one. I didn't realize this was on here. I'm sorry.
This is when they start really screaming.
Yeah.
If you follow my videos, then you would know. The last video with my boyfriend was taking a pregnancy test. And I had said at the end of the video that I left on Valentine's Day because
that's a great video.
He's being mean to me.
There's her mom that she twerks with in videos.
Oh no.
You can do a video if you want.
I like her fingerless gloves.
Yeah.
Pretty dope.
You stole those from Tiffany Lockhart.
Basically,
mom's making a hot
he
pocket.
He got tired of me living with him because mostly one reason. I didn't agree with VR porn. I hate the VR.
Oh, it wasn't in the title. That is the last thing I would have expected to say.
Talk to me so much about just, the stupid VR.
Just listen.
I put on my stupid head like this. I blocked out the whole rest of the world. I heard the brainwashing message about Android sexual monitor here to serve you. I don't even know what it was saying. Like, I don't know. I can't tell what the fuck that thing was saying. Honestly. And then the perspective of the VR made it look like as if my head is lying on my boyfriend's chest looking at his penis while another man is staring at, or while another woman is staring into my eyes. And remember, it's like this. So all I could see is that. Mm-hmm. I can't see anything else in the world.
Good description of VR, man.
And then it looks like my head on some chest with a penis.
Okay.
And then the girl starts taking off her clothes, going down to the penis. I started crying. I was like, I felt like I was forced to watch a girl giving my boyfriend a blowjob.
Yeah.
Okay. So I tried the VR machine. Mm-hmm. I hated it.
Okay.
It made me cry. I felt like I want to kill this girl. You know what I mean? I just did not like that.
Can't be real.
So,
oh,
he began to every day start fights with me about
why though.
That was he wanted me to leave the house.
Why?
And I would leave even just for 10 minutes. I would just go outside, come back in. He would have used the fake pussy VR, and then me and him are not having sex. So, I hate that machine.
Her mom is just right off camera eating a hot pocket at the table.
Finally,
go ahead. Tell us what
after happened. Valentine's Day, I was gone for 3 days. And
yeah, I gotta say, the videos leading up to this are even better than this one because it's the pregnancy arc where they're at Dollar General getting the pregnancy test because he tells her the baby doesn't matter, doesn't care if you spent $1 on the pregnancy test or $20. so they go to Dollar General, they get the pregnancy test, and at the end of the video, it turns out she's not pregnant, and she's very confused because she had some discharge the other day that made her think she was pregnant, and to prove it, she has the tissue and puts it up to the camera.
My gosh.
To show everyone.
Did she think she got pregnant from the VR porn?
No. Well, so, and she tells a story that her and her boyfriend met, and like within a day or two, they decided that they were either going to A, have a baby, or B, make OnlyFans porn. And they decided to make the porn first because the baby could come from, you know what I'm saying? Like, work could become.
Well, that's just smart. Like, you say that like you're making fun of her, but I mean, like, it's two birds, one stone, isn't it?
That's just good planning, isn't it? Yeah. So that's the story of how these two lovebirds met. And he is not the father. This is not the man she picked. And to describe the man that she picked up, that's the baby's daddy. She had gone out with the Beavis and Butthead guy. That's who she refers to him to. That guy turned out to not be a winner. She went home. And somehow met this dude, snuck out to go meet him. She said he's an asshole, but he's really attractive. So, I mean, how does that not work out? All right, it gets better.
He didn't hardly call me or anything at all. So I thought, yeah, he's using that VR machine. He doesn't even think of me. He just goes into his virtual reality and forgets I even exist.
Yeah.
Well. And
then,
it's a smart
I didn't even open his gift on Valentine's Day. It's still here. In the bag.
Did he get it in a claw really machine?
What the fuck?
We haven't is that even a Lilo had and a Stitch good doll? Moment. I went back.
Oh my god, but what's inside of it? The anticipation. Is it a plastic bag?
I haven't opened it. It's like, well,
you
can see what it is.
Oh, what is it? What is it?
Don't open this to your birthday. I don't want to ruin the surprise.
Do you live underwater? Why is it in a plastic bag?
Yeah, I get a goldfish in a bag. He has a Lilo and Stitch doll. Also, you're 30. Why do you have a little plushy doll?
Okay, now you're asking the wrong question. Let's get back to the VR porn and how it causes schizophrenia. Okay? She's gonna be a mother. Give her some space.
I've said this before. There's something I don't like about an adult who has stuffed animals. There's something that creeps me out about it.
Oh, well, look who's gatekeeping adults with stuff. But you're cool with Reborn, who has a fucking bed full of them. He's got that
Reborn has a bunch of Bionicles. Okay, he doesn't have stuffed animals.
You guys have sleepovers, and you know, don't you?
Yes, we play with Beyblades or whatever those were called.
I was getting comments on YouTube about girls were He was asking girls from dating apps to come over and then telling them my YouTube channel.
Yes. But he didn't call me or text me. He was using, he was trying to hook up with girls and using her as a reference of what, look what I can pull. This is my girlfriend. So then girls were hitting her up being like, why is your boyfriend trying to hook up with me? You want to see the talent on my playlist? Yeah, girl, it's my girlfriend. Leave a comment. She'll tell you.
Aw. He's just there fucking his plastic vagina and using his virtual headset to do whatever and like completely ruining my real actual Valentine's Day that I wanted to spend with my boyfriend. And I have $40 to go out and buy him a gift and take us out to eat. Like, I was going to spend that money on him. And instead, I spent the $40 to drive 2 hours away from him.
What?
And then, when I went back, he was talking to the other girls. So, I got mad. And then, he said he was going to break my phone because they were commenting on my YouTube about him, saying, your boyfriend is talking to me on these dating apps. He told me who you are. Just stupid stuff. So then he says he's going to break my phone. And so then I'm holding my phone like this.
Okay.
He tries to grab me and then he can't break my phone. So then he like throws me and I called 911 real quick. So then he ended up being taken overnight. Like I didn't press charges or anything. They just took him overnight because I was scared of him.
Of him? What?
So then his mom says, leave. Never come back. Never ever see him again. So then I pack up all of my stuff out of his house in the car. I leave. And my apartment lease is over. So I have to leave and move back to my mom's house. And so then I'm here at my mom's house, like a couple hours away from where he lives. And then he's like, his mom texts me how he's not doing good. Could I come back? That he's like really sad without me and he loves me, blah, blah, blah. So then I'm like, okay, I'll go back because, you know, I really like him. I care about him.
I can tell.
But then I go back. He's like all like having mental health problems. And it was like scary. Like he's having hallucinations and like schizophrenia. And it was really scary. So then, like, you know, he's calm with me when I'm at his mom's house. But as soon as we take him back to his house, there's that stupid VR machine and the fake plastic vagina just calling.
Does she have gauze on her pants? What is that?
Blah, blah, blah.
They're gloves. Those are her, like, fingerless gloves. Like, they're hand wraps or some
shit. Those are gloves?
Well, they're like some, like, you know, some, I don't know, dude. Look at her. You're gonna there's some sort of...
Love her outfits.
She wears knee pads over like fishnets.
Yeah, she's fucking cool.
Okay, so you're questioning why she has these like weird gloves on? Hold on, she's going to simulate having the VR and fucking the plastic pussy soon. So you don't want to talk over that.
That's true. To see him. He starts being mean to me for the fake pussy. So I'm fed up. I leave. It's the nighttime. I don't want to drive 2 hours. So I call him. I'm like, can I just stay at your house till morning? I go back. He already used the fake pussy in the VR. I was pissed off. He tries to hug me. I said, don't fucking touch me. Yeah, don't touch me at all.
Hug your VR, your precious VR.
Like, you just had your stupid sex. Don't fucking touch me. Like, you know what I mean? He thinks it's not cheating because it's just simulation world. But he's also schizophrenic and thinks the whole world is a simulation.
Now it makes sense. I understand why she's mad now.
Like, it's just, you know, if I'm trying to have a baby with someone, who wants to be having someone that's like addicted to VR sex? And not having sex with
that me should be the concern.
And then, like, kicking me out every day for virtual reality girlfriend. So then I just got super, super mad at him. I told him that I don't ever want to see him again if he's going to keep choosing the VR over me. So he hasn't called me or texted me, nothing at all.
Sounds like he's chosen the VR.
A plastic vagina and VR headset over a real girlfriend. So I'll go ahead and open his dumb gift.
That sucks. George Glass, she's having a baby right now.
It was a lot better when I was with him. And I thought we were going to have gifts together to open and do a video together.
Oh, she unboxed it on her own. Oh, they're going to do a video.
Oh, now she's
opening the whole time.
I wonder what's going on.
This loving boyfriend.
Did this whole thing just turn into an unboxing?
And hold on. She explained that it was going to be a romantic day with her Lilo. Hold on. I got to hear this.
I've turned the leaf. That's a cute doll. I want it.
Yeah, I was going to get him a Doraemon, the little Japanese cartoon that he likes. And I was going to get him a Stitch. And I was going to get him some Nerds cluster candies. But he wanted a virtual girlfriend that can't give him nothing but a plastic pussy and some crazy sex hallucinations.
Crazy sex hallucinations?
No,
he was gonna give him Nerds cluster candy.
With long, look how long that is.
Look at it, it's so cute though. It's actually super soft. At least now I have something to hug. That's
this woman is 30 years old.
So don't you have a baby?
Stupid boyfriend and your virtual porn.
Yeah.
And then he's not even smart enough to have a girlfriend who does real porn. Like I saw real sex videos. There's even some of me and him on my OnlyFans.
Oh, I've seen them.
This is a plug too. She's a, this...
They are fucked.
What? How is this? That is the OnlyFans advertisement.
Oh, hold on. Ready? Hold on. Because that was the hold on. Let's listen to the advertisement and then how she describes it. Because this is good.
I'm on my OnlyFans. This is a promotion right now. If you want to see the couple having sex. Even that, he was kind of lazy. He just wanted me to lay there while he just says, "Hurt me," like as if it's VR. And then he closes his eyes as if it's VR. And I'm like, "No, this is not VR. I'm not VR." Like, you need
again, her mother is like right there.
Sex with me, or else it's boring.
Open your eyes when you have sex with me.
Like, I'm sorry, but who wants to have sex with someone that just lays there with their eyes closed? It makes you do all the work because they want to imagine something because they're so brain fried from VR. And then you add schizophrenia on top. And, you know, I start to think the schizophrenia is probably caused by overusing the VR.
Yeah.
To where you're constantly.
I don't think that's backed by science.
Just in real life, you tell your girlfriend, leave so you can have sex with a plastic vagina and go to the VR porn.
Mm-hmm.
Like, honestly, who wants to be with somebody like that?
Hold on. Well, can you stimulate it for us?
I just disagree with it. I disagree with the whole entire stupid VR thing.
Mm-hmm.
I think, yeah, it's fine if you're like single and you're not, don't have mental health problems and you stop using it and you're not going to be comparing your girlfriend to plastic hole.
Saying,
I like this plastic hole much better.
It's a little fucking
water. Come on, I have a plastic dick also with a vibrator and a battery, but guess what? I still get lonely just because I have a plastic dick. Plastic dick doesn't cure my anxiety.
Good point.
Plastic dick doesn't cure my anxiety. That's a donation sound.
That's a t-shirt.
plastic dick don't cure my anxiety. There's also another video where it's called "Why Do Chinese Men Prefer Sex Dolls to Real Women?" And in it, he ordered himself a sex doll, and it's going to take 6 to 8 weeks to get there. And she is very upset, and she's like, "So you like a plastic sex doll more than me?" And he says, "It hasn't even gotten here yet, so I don't know."
When it does, we'll compare.
He said, "I don't know." He said, "You won't even let me get it so I can see." And then he ends up canceling it. He goes, "There, I canceled. Are you happy now? Now I have no sex doll." He said, "When I want to play games, sex doll just lays there. I have sex with sex doll. I can go back to playing games. It's not going to be doing a lot of talk." So, like, for as out there as he still makes way more sense than Zika does sometimes.
He's got to figure it out.
Look, I do karate in front of the camera.
And when I used his VR thing, it made me feel weird. It made me feel like stupid for a whole day after. Like, and I only used it for 10 minutes. It made me feel really stupid afterwards.
Well, you're the one who said you're getting mad at the VR girl. You should feel stupid.
Truth reason why I did not want to be with someone that likes VR porn, and he wanted to fight me constantly on it. To where, if he's not willing to let go or make compromises, like, I even told him, you could watch regular porn and, like, you know, tell me, hey, I want to watch porn. And, like, I told him he can give me money. I would go shopping. He could watch his regular porn. But the VR is too much, like, you're cheating on me.
Yeah.
And he
give her money so she can go shopping so he can watch porn? Like, it's
cheating.
Yeah.
He can go have all the sex with all the virtual girls. And then I'm just supposed to lay in bed by myself because he started a fight and told me to leave, then asked me to come back after he gets off in the plastic vagina. And then I'm there depressed because I'm like, why is this stupid machine better than me?
That's a good question.
Who wants me to be?
Don't ask questions you don't want the answer to.
Machine.
Yeah.
And what? A plastic hole. A what? Thing that looks like this that he sticks his dick in.
All right, here we go.
Oh, yeah. That's how you
hold
do
on,
it.
Hold
okay.
on, hold on, hold on.
Hold on.
Yeah, please. Give Blue Boy an illustration.
Let's simulate him.
Thank you. A simulation of a simulation. What?
And I bet you everyone watching this was thinking, I wonder how this works.
Yeah, we're going to find out. Here we go.
Oh,
basically him with his VR thing.
Yeah.
Is this the best way to do this?
Yeah. Like, you're real stupid. Well, I can't see nothing, Mom. You have to tell me
where's
the fake pussy. Here's
the where's the fake pussy,
Mom? Where's the fake pussy, Mom?
That's not a statement you would say to your mother.
Oh my god.
Imagine if you came in this part of the stream.
Crying myself to sleep.
Now she reenacted the
thanks
crime.
For reenacting what sleepy looks like, yeah.
Because of that one reason.
Mm-hmm. That's it. Everything else was gravy.
Not even
gravy
the
train.
Fights, not even because the drama.
Nope.
Not even because he's lazy and messy and spends all his money on candy.
Yeah, well,
because the VR
money on candy
machine,
candy and plastic pussy.
Every time you go,
this guy's living the life.
Every time he leaves the room to go outside, that he's gonna be having some crazy sex orgy simulation, and then when he gets back and sees you, you're not gonna be cool because he wants to be there in a crazy sex orgy. Well, now I don't have a boyfriend.
Thanks, VR. Thanks, Mark Zuckerberg.
And I'm sad again.
Aww.
Back to being sad.
Aww. Pickles.
So, yeah, that's what happened. I'll stop talking now.
What?
But this is why VR porn ruined my life.
I mean, wow.
See, and I can do this. I want to watch another one.
It should not be legal for this person to be pregnant right now.
What are you talking about?
No! I was having like an anxiety attack. I was like, no, you can't do this.
That should be legal.
Do you really want to watch another one? Do you want to see if I can find the pregnancy one?
Another good one.
Yes, please.
They're all good.
Let me, I'll put on cold drinks while I find one.
Drinks. Cold. Are you ready? Here we go. Soft drinks, lemonade, water, cold tea. It's up to you. It's up to me. Cold drinks come in 4 cups. Gotta know the size before you fill it up. Biggie, medium, small, kids meal. Keep it straight. It's a good deal. Use the scoop to fill with ice. Never use the cup. Take my advice. But soft drinks fill the ice halfway. No matter the size, that's what I say. Tilt the cup and push against the lever. Keeps the foam down now. Isn't that clever? If there's still foam, let it settle down. Don't pour it off, or your boss will frown. When you reach a quarter inch from the top,
That's where you wanna stop. If the customers say they wanna stay, put the drink on the left-hand side of the tray. If the order's to go, put the lid on tight. Make sure it pops to do it right. Then hand that drink to the coordinator and tell the guest you'll see him later.
Don't forget to smile when you serve cold drinks. Always say thank you to the guest. You're the one that can make the difference.
For lemonade, things stay the same, half full with ice. I said it again, fill the juice to a quarter inch from the top, just like you did the pop. Water is a courtesy to our guests. Use a small cup, you know the rest. Now it's time to serve cold tea, but the ice is different, listen carefully. Instead of half full, fill it all the way up to the top of the cup. Add the tea, and if they ask for a lemon...
You were great in that, Slofcut.
We're going to watch VR causes schizophrenia. Boyfriend chooses virtual girlfriend and headset porn instead of real sex. Because I can't find that other channel that had the pregnancy test one, but I'll have it ready for that next one. Blue, but we have to do a secret stream.
Yes, we do.
Right. Like, all right. So we'll play this one and then we're going to be out.
Okay. And you were having virtual sex with however.
Wow, that is
whatever you wanted to do in the virtual sex world and trashing the house, and then you break up with me when I come back and I feel hurt.
No, what do you want me to do?
Can't you respect me? Respect me.
You can't back to me. I think you know me enough to know I told you what I like. I told you I like what I don't like. There's certain things I don't like so much that if you do so much I would lose control. I'll give my control to somebody else. Be like, I can't handle this. It just triggers me like too much. Like, now using that mechanism too much, that now just triggers like my ultimate self to just constantly just like you, like just like it's like it's my mechanism. You want to reverse engineer me every time that I change my mechanism, so like it's useless waste of time.
All I did was ask him to clean and stop fucking cheating on me with the VR porn. I don't give a fuck if he watches regular porn, but the VR porn is makes me feel cheated on. He just knows he's not the girl you're looking for. Fine.
All these videos, by the way, have like 7 views.
He doesn't
views
care
tops
about me or love me or respect.
That's the thing. So, yeah. She talks about this being her career, but yeah, she gets like no one watches these videos. So like she does this for nothing. For nothing.
Every fucking day. How bad I am for being here. How I make him like a slave for wanting a home that I could feel like is my home also. He doesn't care about anything but himself.
Why would he do that to you?
I wish I could stay in my house.
Why didn't you solve it by yourself? Like the cleaning issue is brought by you. Before you came here, there wasn't a cleaning issue here.
Okay, well.
And most, like, if the cleaning was too bad, like somebody like my mom comes in, especially just for cleaning the house.
Yeah, see?
When she thinks like it's all way too bad.
If things get too bad, his mom comes and cleans up. Like, what's the issue?
No, like she comes in all the way to come to clean the house. But most times I self-regulate. I just like, I leave a little bit messy. I keep a little bit messy. That's before you came to this house that it has a this peaceful feeling of like slightly messy house most of the time. Sounds very messy. It's like always going. It's like dynamic house. You know what I mean?
Dynamic.
I like dynamic more than like a sterilized house. So all the time, same house. I don't know. Maybe some people like that. Like, dynamic house is always changing. It's like a day.
He's
like,
insane.
House, like, I just want the house to be clean.
He liked the dynamic.
I'm gonna try that next time. My wife tells me to clean up. Like, hey, the house is just on empty. This is my style.
Come on, just fucking help clean the house and stop cheating on me virtually. But you don't even like me enough to even think about why that matters. All you think about is you. This girl is so annoying. I don't like her. I can't believe she wants to clean. Oh, I don't like her. She doesn't want me to have virtual sex with other women. I don't like her. I don't like her at all. I'm gonna tell her every day I don't like her.
I never told you I don't like you. I told you.
You told me 20 you. Videos.
I have to. I look at you. I tell myself I like you very much. I like you. Like,
you don't tell me that.
I tell myself.
I like you. I love you. I tell you how many times I tell you I love you. It's like not never enough times. Can I just tell you with my eyes most of the time?
I just tell you with my eyes most of the time.
There's something in my book, we're getting tried, but when you say something too many times, You think to try it, then you think you self-consider it lame.
All I'm saying is help clean and stop cheating on me with your virtual sex. I don't care if you jerk off and watch porn on the TV when I'm gone, but if you're using your VR, that's cheating. And I,
how is that different?
I don't want to cheat.
I don't know.
If you're cheating on me, have some fucking respect for your girlfriend.
I don't know, that's how we're different.
That's a respect.
That's the difference. You don't respect me, exactly.
From multiple points that I agree with, like you don't want to, you know, I guess you don't want to agree on anything. You never agreed on a single thing I said. I'm not kept to explain, but I'll explain anyway. Like, first of all, we are sex, home, we are have sex. I think you're mixing the three. Like, it's just like anytime you think about we are sex, you jump your mind to like we are sex, and you think we are sex is cheating. All these are like, they're just like old concepts that they implant on us to stop these things from going like popular, to promote,
okay,
like to promote, like maybe like they want to stop we are to promote we are whores, you know what I mean?
Like
that.
What?
Say we are whores.
And now these things don't happen anymore. Don't have this competition
he
anymore.
Does not respect his girlfriend. That's all he's saying. He just wants to
I don't
use
think that's
VR
what he's
for
saying.
No, that's not what he's saying
at all.
That's not.
He doesn't like his girlfriend enough to feel like VR porn is not cheating. And when I say that, it makes me want to go out and cheat on him, because every time I leave the house, he goes and fucks these girls virtually. I know it's technology. I know it's a technology advancement. It's way more sophisticated.
Look at her. She is having a breakdown.
For like a long time, I just like.
On Valentine's Day. On Valentine's Day, we didn't even go out. You didn't even do
Cupid's
nothing.
Birthday.
You left in the morning. I don't know.
Yes, because I wanted you to fucking get up and be nice to me. You told me you're mad that I'm in your bed on Valentine's Day.
I woke up. I feel very strange. I feel like I got nicotine bars.
This is me.
I got a strange. I felt like I got.
he doesn't know what is going on. I don't think.
Make me sleepy, and then make you hate me in the process.
You make me hate you on yourself.
Like the doctor,
it's you don't respect me.
You don't respect me. I want to show interesting, like in that morning, like they prescribe me with something called the, I don't know. This makes like doctors make it for the influence of things. You know what I mean? Making you.
He doesn't respect me.
You have
all kind of
reasons to not like me.
Yeah.
Just find one that you think.
Finally, he stops moving.
I guess this
right here.
That's why I'm acceptable. Like, you don't like me for this reason. I'm just like.
Well, you're being mean to me. All because I come home after 3 days of being alone on Valentine's Day because you didn't want me in your house on Valentine's Day.
I wasn't in your house. I told you like I was so bored. I took a lot of time. I had to mute.
You didn't
myself.
Even call me for 2 days. Like, he didn't call me. He's like, just jerking off to VR porn.
I was not.
He is. I can tell because he starts talking about controlling people by looking at them with their eye, and people are sex robots. Come on.
I wasn't talking about that. Why do you want me to? Why do you always?
You did talk about that.
You want to remind me of somebody else that's not me, like.
Maybe you know somebody looks like me that's not me.
You're in his house.
Like, an important point. That's very intellectual. Intellectual people use it to like attack people. You know what I mean? Like it's smartly, and you use that a lot. I don't like that type of talk.
This is why I kill you because you're such a liar. Go away from.
What is he lying about? He's speaking gibberish.
What is he lying about?
just for background, she has been arrested. She has been arrested several times for domestic violence, and also
she's not exactly the most stable.
Yeah, and then drug arrests, but there are some domestic violence arrests in there too. She claims of DID, and all of her identities have different channels.
They're all YouTubers.
My favorite is Paul McStrudel cake. Paul McStrudel cake is my.
I like Trash a Deer.
Well, Trash a Deer is pretty endearing. I will give Trash a Deer that. I think the 70-minute intervention parody that she made. That some people believe is an actual episode of Intervention, and other people just get really mad because of the way they say she's making fun of addicts. Yeah, she's a mess.
Hey. retard. I feel like you're using intellectual attacks on a retard is kind of discriminatory.
Get away from me, okay? Why did I ever come back here? I wish I had never brought my stuff to your fucking house. I wish I never met you. I wish I never brought my stuff here. I wish I could stay at my own house.
Make sure my hair looks good in the camera.
Then just be nice. Be nice to me.
I don't know.
Be nice to me.
This is Tiffany talking to me.
Fuck.
Please don't.
Fucking nice to me. You don't respect yourself. You didn't clean the house. All I said is help clean. Help clean and stop having
virtual
sex.
I can't take this anymore. But you can't just keep screaming the same thing again and again and expect me to be like.
Then I just want to go. I just want to leave. I wish I never brought my stuff here. I wish I never brought my stuff here.
I just don't get why she's recording this.
I want to spend time with you, but I think that's too selfish for your needs because your needs are obviously greater. Your needs. For a clean house at your own home, maybe greater than spending time with me. Like, you don't want spending time with me on the first thing you do, you just want screaming about having a need of a clean house.
I wanted
house.
To come home to a comfortable house, and then I wanted you to see that I'm uncomfortable with the mess and clean it and do something nice for me for Valentine's Day, something to show me you care about me.
I love the stomping on the ground.
I want to do something. About doing things.
You thought about it.
I thought about it. I thought you'd leave me on the first day. And the whole time I was thinking about it, like, the whole time I was playing my head the game of, like, I guess when you leave, I gotta play this game I don't really like. It's like, in previous life, I was tortured for a long time, sort of like after I broke up with my ex girlfriend. Like, I spent a long time, in a solitary, like, living. Like, I have to, like, see.
I actually understand on that.
Yeah. Do you? Because I think they should call him a doctor. He's not fucking. He's not right.
Go away from me. I have you said something similar. I have you go through something similar that makes me sense? Like, it doesn't make me sense pain anymore. That's in that life. You know what I mean? But it makes me feel sense something similar to, like, just not good. You know what I mean? Like, just like it's a negative. Because I still think it's negative. I'll be like, not that lifetime of training. Like, of seeing like these things like this. Like, I don't like seeing. Like, they try to train me. Use your generation's method of training me into me thinking like this.
Your generation?
It works a little bit, because I want to show you that your generation will be trained at some point.
She's so confused.
I didn't understand the last part. She went too far.
I just don't know why you record this and then upload it.
Right.
Most of the time, unless you come back, then you switch back to reality. But get like the most time you left, I already think you're cheating on me. Like, my head is like, I'm half convinced, maybe like sometimes I'm mostly convinced, sometimes I'm less convinced. I'm between the switch between the two, like the electricity between the two. Sometimes I'm more convinced you are cheating on me, sometimes I'm less convinced you're cheating on me. Sometimes I think it's a show, sometimes I think it's like some cartoon or some
alternative
dimension series. That you have, like, you alternative you having
sex and not one for porn, one for gaming, I assume. Like,
I'm thinking all this.
The porn and gaming chair.
Like, similar like getting spam, you know?
Can't jerk in the same chair you play games.
She's texting her mom. I need to come back, mom. It didn't work out. This dude takes a lot of steps.
I was going to say he's getting his steps in today. Yeah. Pacing back and forth.
That Fitbit is.
Look, man, he should have just went and called the Super Swole Frog police.
Well, that's not a real thing. Okay, that was just an icon. I believe she... is just...
so
why are you... They're there.
And I feel so alone.
Okay, I don't like being alone. Like I don't like being alone. That's why I like seeing you. Like, even now seeing you again, like, just makes me instantly happy. Like, I'm gonna see you, like, that's why I like you. Probably, like, even though honestly, I don't like some of the times, some ways you act, but like, that's the definition of laughing, or approach or something like that. You just think of perfect love is better than the perfect love. I don't think it's possible. Is that sure lasted? This got snatched by aliens, so we think perfection is like, yeah, what's that? Perfection. So they snatch all the perfection and leave the perfect for mankind on earth.
And they're not having a baby because of the VR porn. Just a reminder. It's the VR porn that broke this relationship down. He talks and she doesn't even pay attention because she knows that she doesn't understand what he's saying.
Perfection is like to be an Earth citizen on Earth. It needs to be like adequate.
I was trying to be romantic for 1 second till you start talking about aliens and everyone else on Earth.
No,
stupid fucking simulations. I'm sick of it.
No.
Why can't you ever care about me? Why can't you ever care about me, your girlfriend? You start to make me feel better for 2 seconds, and then you start saying, oh, but then sometimes I don't like you.
Is she trying to force a schizophrenic person?
Yes. Yeah.
To just love her and not be schizophrenic?
It's like how something Lauren would do. Like, this would be Lauren with Winnie.
Yeah, that's...
How frustrated she is. Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
And I was about to say, it's like she's literally trying to say that he should just not be schizophrenic anymore based off of his love for her.
Yeah. Yeah, and so, I mean, and she knows this, right? She knows this, yet she's getting upset with him for being schizophrenic. And it's the VR's fault. Because he goes in there and he feels like he's in the virtual, and he comes out and doesn't know the difference. So he's in there cheating on her. Again, she is 9 weeks pregnant with the gas station dude. And Blue Boy, you believe that the guy works at the gas station, right?
That's what I thought. I thought she like went to the gas station and just was like, hey, you guy behind the counter. And then they just like had sex at the lake.
Well, but I mean, who would have worked his shift?
It was after work.
So she so they met and then she went.
Because I thought she said she had to pick him up.
She did. She did say that, but I thought because dude lives with a girl, he was like, yo, I'm gonna go take a 3 hour, I'm gonna go jog or I'm gonna go work out or something, and he walked down to the gas station, you know, like you can't pick me at my place when I live with, so then that was just their central meeting place. So I assumed he just walked there, but he could have worked at the gas station. That also makes sense. Yeah. So, and he's an asshole, but very good looking. So that's what we know about the baby's father.
Yeah, and that's why I don't like you using the VR. It makes you fucking schizophrenic.
What
it makes you schizophrenic.
Why do you have embedded characters like that? That I look to get rid of. Like.
What are you talking about? Why do I have characters you look to get rid of? Why do you hate me?
What?
Tough life being an influencer. We got to put it all on camera.
Yeah, I know.
The public needs it. This is what they want. They want the real, raw emotions.
This is like fake sobbing, I feel like, at this point.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Like, come on, dude.
Doing it for the six people who are going to watch the video. Although that video earlier, dude, had 40 views. The one she
probably... Me and you.
Well, maybe.
I wish I had a fucking home again.
Aww.
What'd you say?
I wish I had a home again. I just want to go home.
Boo-boo.
Now it's me. Maybe we got switched to different.
Oh my god.
What are you talking about? You're not saying anything about how I care. You're just talking like you used too much VR for the 3 days that I've gone.
Oh my god. Really,
he said,
lady?
Maybe. He said, maybe you're mad at the wrong person. Maybe while you were gone, I was switched out with someone else. And she's like, see, too much VR porn. That is not a result of VR porn.
No.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just clean. Show us the house. Just candy boxes. Ice cream containers on the ground.
There's a bunch of soda.
You just argue and treat me like that's crap another... until I do it.
Then turn the camera off and go home.
Just go. Get your shit and go.
I give up everything and I bring all my stuff to this fucking place where I'm always told, take it. Take it. Leave. After I do all this work to make a nice house.
Only like when you like think about me as a computer, when you type in random keys, when you type in like
I don't do that. I just say, please stop cheating on me with VR. VR is making you schizophrenic.
What do you mean?
Look at the way you're talking. You can't even relate to me as a human. You're just saying I'm a game character.
Schizophrenic. VR maybe cures my issues can be cured with VR.
No.
A lot of my issues can be cured with VR.
You started to be normal the last month.
Like, stop sending like a lot of people like the Japanese culture, a lot like American culture has a hatred on some of the new stuff. Like,
it's like, not so, that like,
because they're new.
What the fuck is he talking about?
Style, you get it, like the VR machine we've been using in the 1600s to train like students to people to watch.
I don't think they had VR in the 1600s.
Everybody's trained by VR. Like early, everybody like in the government, they were trained by VR. They were acting. They just saw what people acting in government, what robots saw when they acted. A robot's government.
Please tell me, how is any of this gonna make your life with your relationship better? Any of this? How is any of what you're saying going to fix the problem between me and you?
I'm just defending like the next one. I'm just bored like defending technology.
It's defending technology.
Technology, man. You should be leave technology alone.
I'm not worried about our relationship, bitch. What did you say about technology? They were using VR in the 1600s. You were seeing what robots see.
You feel like you're just having virtual sex with other people every time I leave. Can't you stop? Can't you stop doing that? Can't you respect me and stop doing that?
Satisfying my complex needs.
Are you able to satisfy me?
I think so.
How? I've been saying since I got home an hour ago to clean.
I don't know.
You know that bowl is dirty. Why just move it to that corner? You know it's dirty.
That's the dirty bowl corner.
You're running your relationship into the ground, and for what?
VR porn.
Waiting for three. You know, something that triggered some secrets about reality.
You're waiting for me to clean?
Can I tell you some secrets about reality?
Are you waiting for me to clean?
Listen, he's comfortable living in the film.
Reality.
Can I tell you some things about reality?
I would like to know.
Like, you are two very different conversations right now. You are trying to have a conversation about a relationship, and this man wants to explain reality and how they were using VR in the 1600s. Like, seriously, Sika, you have to see that, right? And she's like, you're not talking.
She's too busy
like...
looking at herself in the fucking camera.
She's saying you're not relating. She's saying you're not even trying to relate to me while she's staring into the camera.
Sometimes we walk around, like, you know, some bugs move. Like the bugs, they always move, then they start moving, right?
Yeah.
Have you noticed that? Bugs, they move, they start moving. They don't use any electricity, they don't have to eat, right? Humans, if we don't move, like we control our moves, just set certain motions, we control our moves by waiting, we can get what's called free energy slot. Like maybe every second there's like 0.25 seconds.
No, you're going to clean up the mess. You're not going to make this guy, me do it. And then
he should write a screenplay.
You're a slave when I have to clean up everything for you.
Saying, like,
clean up the mess. Go make the bed.
But you have to get me. Like, I'm going to wait till my free energy slot.
You're not
okay. That ain't making sense. You gotta wait for that free energy slot. At first, it didn't make sense.
Cornville 3, are you still here? Oh. Well, and that was it. Yeah, let's not. That was it. What did you think of that? Blue Boy, you're still here?
Control them.
No, I'm still here.
I think we lost Cornville three-way.
What did I think of muted. It?
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, I don't even what
you
to
love
think.
You,
it's
you love you some Sika, right?
I do love me some Sika, just because it's so fucked. I mean, that's not even the best video. Yeah. There's so many good ones that are
No, yeah, there really
cooking,
are. There,
spicy
there are a ton.
Beef. Like, what the fuck is happening?
We will put together a playlist, and we will do a proper Sika stream, because I feel she has so much content. There are hundreds and hundreds of videos. There is so much content.
Right. She uploads it daily, like several times a day.
And you and I will just go back and forth. Did you hear this at whatever minute? The one today, though, especially. God, I'm really disappointed she took that down, but I'm glad I downloaded it before.
That's crazy. She took that one down, but left that up.
Well, that one, that one's fine. The one where she's simulating fucking the plastic pussy, that one is also fine. But yeah, let's close out with a Perry Caravello blow up. Okay, you guys good with that?
Sure.
And then Blue Boy, you had a song that you wanted to close the show with. You remember? So I have that one queued up.
That's right.
But first let's watch Perry get really. Oh, this was a lead up to his interview with Chris Hansen. So I was giving him some interview prep.
But here too, when we interview, I don't know if this stuff's going to come up, but if it does, Perry, you're going to want to pay attention, okay?
Fine.
Number one, Chris hates rapists, okay? So don't brag about the RC situation. I don't know who sucked.
What are you fucking talking about, you sick fucking pervert? Fuck you! I'm not bringing it up! And never to be discussed ever again! And all you motherfuckers do is keep bringing it up! So stop it! Stop it! Stop it! Stop it now!
I think we're saying the same thing here, buddy. I'm saying don't bring it up. Like,
thank you.
Don't talk about it. If he says, have you ever sexually assaulted an older man, you would just say no.
Never sexually assaulted anybody.
Exactly. Oh, we're doing great now. Yeah, just a deny. And if he asks me, I'll do like a mm-hmm. So if he says, have you ever jacked off a man for sack cards? Like, if that just comes out.
Mind your own fucking business, fucker!
No, don't say that. I'm gonna say that
to anybody, and you don't even say that to you! You sick fucking pervert! Mind your own!
I can't imagine Chris is...
Mind your own fucking business!
That's a lot of energy for a YouTube interview, so maybe you want to bring it... I like it. I like where you're going, but bring it down a couple levels. And it also makes you look guilty if he asks you if you've ever sucked a dude off.
I never sucked off anybody, you sick fucking animal! I never sucked off any man! I'm not into gay oral sex at all!
I mean, yeah, sure, that might work. I'd say to be more calm when you deny. But okay, then when you admit what you did to RC, do me a favor, because this is really good for the camera.
Well, I admit.
Look down at the floor, then look up at the camera. Take a pause. We call it a beat, and then say, "Yes, I raped that old man."
Good day.
Oh, here we go.
Hey, no.
Good fucking day. You sick fucking asshole! I never raped anybody! I was sexually assaulted! Sexually assaulted! You sick son of a bitch! This stream is done! Today! Stream is over! Get the fuck off me! I'm done! I'm done! I'm fucking done! You son of a bitch! That son of a fucking bitch! I don't ever want to hear his voice again. I don't ever want to hear from him ever again. We're done.
All right, but like, you know, a few days later, he said we could be best friends, so he doesn't stick to his guns. But yeah, that was me and my buddy Perry. And for anyone who doesn't know, Perry gave a man sexual hand favors in exchange for SAG cards. That's what happened in 1992. So that was it. That was me and my good buddy, Perry Caravello. So yeah, Blue Boy, guys, go ahead and do your outros, and then we will get to Blue Boy. We'll cue up this closing out song that he had. Go ahead. Oh shit, we got a donation while we were watching the sequel. Oh, I'm so sorry. Polynomial Purbred said, now I don't know what to do if they ask for lemon in their cold. You know, we'll play cold drinks next time, Polynomial Purbred, and we'll dedicate that one to you. We'll open with it, so you'll know exactly what to do with the cold drinks. And then and then Richard Roberts said, why does Blue Boy let his wife film this? That's a good question, Blue Boy. Why do you?
It's her career. I support her career.
Yeah, you can't fuck with that. She's got a job to do. You sound like Richard Roberts. You sound like Lorne right now with how you don't want to be supportive of a woman's career. All right. So Slothcat, did you say bye? I wasn't paying attention.
All up in ya, like Benya, and we ain't talking gullah.
Mm, all right. And then go ahead, Blue Boy.
All right, Blue Crew. Good to see you. Thanks for stopping by.
And then Cornville Three-Way.
See you later, guys.
All right. And Blue Boy, what song are we going out with today, and what's this all about?
I don't know.
But you chose the song.
I don't know.
All right, perfect. Great.
What was I supposed to say?
I thought you had like a whole little speech written.
Oh, no. I don't have a speech.
You're such a piece of shit. All right. Thank you so much, guys. I'll be back sometime this week with another Lauren stream, probably a Jesse stream too. So if I don't see you before then. Oh, I'll have a Riffin' with Reborn too. I'll be doing another one of those.
Sleep. Wow.
Fire. Beat him up. Yeah, I'ma beat him up. Yeah, hey. When I find Oprah Winfrey, I'ma beat her up.
He just knocked the cherry out, so I'ma beat him up.
When I find Barry White, I'ma beat him up.
When I find Odell, I'ma beat him up.
When I find Barack Obama, I'ma beat him up.
When I find Raya.
When I find Mariah Carey, I'ma beat her up.
When I find R. Kelly, I'ma beat him up.
When I find the Secretary of Defense, I'ma beat her up.
Got too drunk and I'ma be my bitch cause I just beat her up.
When I die and find Kobe Bryant, I'ma beat him.
It's up to you, it's up to me. Cold drinks.
come in 4 cups. Gotta know the size before you fill it up. Biggie, medium, small, kids meal. Keep it straight, it's a good deal. Use the scoop to fill with ice. Never use the cup, take my advice. For soft drinks, fill the ice halfway. No matter the size, that's what I say. Tilt the cup and push against the lever. Keeps the foam down now, isn't that clever? If there's still foam, let it settle down. Don't pour it off, or your boss will frown. When you reach a quarter inch from the top, that's where you wanna stop. If the customers say they wanna stay, put the drink on the left-hand side of the tray. If the order's to go, put the lid on tight. Make sure it pops to do it right. Then hand that drink to the coordinator and tell the guest you'll see him later.
Don't forget to smile when you serve cold drinks. Always say thank you. You're the one that can make the difference.
For lemonade, things stay the same, half full with ice. I said it again, fill the juice to a quarter inch from the top, just like you did the pop.